you're gonna meet a bitch, that's where you're gonna meet one. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, hey.
Give me a sip of that.
What?
Come on! My throat's dry as a motherfucker.
Why? Is your mother dry when you...
What the fuck is that, huh?
Nothing.
Well, it didn't sound like nothing, all right? It didn't seem like nothing. I don't think that it was nothing.
I didn't mean nothing by it, old man.
Old man? Old man!
Fuck you, you creepy old motherfucker. That's right. I said it. Creepy. Old! Motherfucker!
No! Jesus!
Huh?
No, come on!
What?
Sorry,
where
sorry.
Were we
on,
exactly,
get up,
huh?
Get up! I'm sorry, man, we're sorry!
Help! Help! There's a guy with a gun!
Hey, bud. What you do?
Nothing. What you up to, Cletus?
Hunting.
Hunting what? Retirees?
Nah, just stuff. Windows, antenna, tires, vermin.
Ah, so that was you. 'Tis the season for it.
I don't give a shit about no season.
Oh, good, huh? Don't let the regulations get you down.
That's what I'm saying. Hey, you want to come hunting with me? It'd be real neighborly of you.
Hell. Why not?
All right, then. Up here with you. I got just a thing. Let's raise some hell, neighbor.
Oh, I'm in.
I'll introduce you to one of my all-time favorite pastimes.
You're gonna love this.
Okay, you see them three big satellite dishes? A decent shot, and they'll go down easier than a whore's drawers.
You're a real pillar of the community.
Half the folks in this town would sell their own mother, and most of the other half already dead. Screw them. Yeah, that's it. Give them hell. Shoot another one. No more reality TV for you, Mrs. Gilbert. Okay, one more for the road. How long does it take? Hey, where are you going? Come on, it ain't like they're running away from you. What the hell? Makes you feel alive, don't it? Sticking it to the man.
Or sticking it to Bill Henderson on Island Avenue. Keep us out of trouble.
Boom! Didn't I tell you this would be more fun than a barrel full of pussies?
Ooh, you're a classy date, Cletus. No denying that.
Now drive us up to that abandoned motel. I got an even better idea.
So, what now?
We're gonna try our luck on something less stationary.
Ooh, liberals?
Nothing as slippery as that. You'll see. Be lucky if we make it there today on foot. Ain't she a beauty? Drives like a dream.
You've got way too much time on your hands.
Nah, this is just a bit of foolery. I've been busier than hell with the real hunting. The money in wild organic meat these days, you wouldn't believe. Them hipsters will give you their parents' last dime for it. It's gotten so I can't even keep up with the demand no more. All this eat local, small batch, farm to table bullshit. You know, I could maybe use another pair of hands if I can get you up to snuff with that rifle.
You keep on criticizing my shooting, you'll be starring in a snuff with that rifle.
Here we are. I bet you never shot out the tires on a car before.
Oh, you'd be surprised.
Well, let's see what you got then.
Ain't you gonna shoot anything, Cletus?
Nah, I do this all the time, and I wanna see how you deal with a moving target. You ain't gonna get far without a gun. This is perfect right here. Pick a car and shoot a tire. Good, plain, old-fashioned fun. Nice! Go on, one more, just for the hell of it. That's it, beauty! And again, Trevor. Trevor. Hellfire, Trevor, you ain't rushing this, are you? Man, not too bad, Trevor. Right, let's change it up. Come on, follow me. Seen that before. G Just two fellers killing time in small town America. Don't get much better than this, does it?
The two most popular guys in town.
Am I glad I ran into you? Ain't nowhere near this fun being antisocial on your own.
Whatever cranks your tractor, I say. What's up next on the hillbilly anarchist agenda?
Ever shot anything with a face? Actually, let me ask it again. Ever shot anything with a face on four legs?
Now, Cletus, it's important you realize I'm a man plagued by vicious rumors.
Fine. Let's head for the roof. I seen some coyotes hanging around down by the road. Reckon it would be real neighborly of us to get rid of a couple.
And we are nothing if not neighborly.
We'll get a better shot from up here. See him. Looks like we got two packs of coyotes down there. Take a few of them out, and the rest should scatter. Gotta line them up good. Ha! Sing to me now, song dog! And another. Dropped it like a bad habit. I think you got one more in you, Trevor. What? That should do it. Nicely done. I reckon you should tag along next time I go hunting out at Polito Bay. I'll show you how to bag an elk.
Why not?
All right, gotta go. I'll send you a text when I'm about.
Thank you. There you are, handsome.
No mud.
How have you been?
Oh, simply wonderful. And you?
About the same. Somewhere stuck between joyful and peachy. Even in this world full of scum and detritus, it's only right that we all bear our share.
Ain't that the truth?
Take this poor wretch, on the run, desperate, alone, about to learn the true meaning of suffering, all for a few thousand bucks. Think you can find him for me?
Every man has his talents, Maud, and the rigorous administration of justice is one of mine.
That's why I love you, Trevor. I'll send you his file.
Kill it, I buy a morgue in the minute. The public house, the plastic couch of a Section 8 tenant. The regal window is tinted, the air conditioner broke, but I'm cool enough to ensure you my ride is an Eskimo, huh? And I peel off in the midst of getting my clothes off, and I drop off energy from inner cities that we lost, huh? I'm putting a ghetto on top of my back, and I live in the back of the...
Back here. You're not even hidden. You got it? I've been trying, Trevor. I've been trying. Come on over here, all right? I ain't gonna hit you. I've been trying.
I know, I know.
I thought you said you weren't gonna hit me. I thought you said you were gonna find fucking Michael Townley.
There's two
Michael Townley, living in L.S. One is 83, and the other one is at kindergarten. I asked the teacher to put him on the phone just to be safe. She threatened to call the cops. I ain't no molester, Trevor.
Shut up before I molest you, all right? Now, is there anything else?
I look through the phone directory. I did find a Michael DeSanta, about the right age, married with two kids.
What's his wife's name?
Amanda?
Amanda?
Yeah.
You're a genius, you moron. Come on, come here.
Woo!
Don't you ever not tell me things I want to know!
Sorry, Trevor.
Run, you little bastard! Get out here! We're going to Los Santos.
Are we?
Not you, me and Wade.
What about me?
You're CEO of Trevor Phillips Enterprises. Find us some business so that we can make some money. And tidy my shit up. Let's go, Wade, come on. I'm driving. You can jerk me off if I get bored. I'm joking. You can suck me off.
We gonna stop for ice cream? So we're heading to Los Santos then?
Soon.
I gotta make a stop.
Oh, what's the stop? Ice cream?
Where are your people at in Los Santos?
It's just my cousin there, Floyd. He's bunked in with his girlfriend someplace called Vespucci Beach. So, what's the stop?
Family's important, Wade. Not as important as the man that's employed you, mentored you, and fed you amphetamine this last year, but it's important. We gotta pay this cousin a visit.
I ain't seen him in a while, Trevor.
All the more reason to drop by.
Okay, not my big eyes, but where are we stopping on the way?
For fuck's sake! Another chapter of the Lost descended on this fine town. Looking to mourn, maybe revenge their dead. I was thinking me and you could pay our respects.
Trevor, I don't think we'd be welcome there. I mean, what do you want to, well, send them on their way to begin with?
Grief has a beautiful way of bringing folk together, Wade. Just you wait. And besides, I brought some gifts.
Coming guys? Like flowers or a cake?
Shut up. The Lost Camp. Ooh, I got some fond memories of this. didn't piss me off. The guys that killed him, the federal government, they pissed me off.
But if he's dead, who's this?
Now you're starting to grasp the pertinent questions. Who is this guy using my dead friend's tired-ass movie quotes, with my dead friend's alias, and my dead friend's family? And a house that must have been paid for with my dead friend's stashed millions?
Wow, that's a real mind fuck.
I'll show you a fucking mind fuck. I'm gonna stick my boy in your eye. It's gonna come out of your ear, huh?
I didn't mean anything by that, P. Trevor!
Lube up your eye hole, fucker! Cause I'm gonna fuck your tiny mind, huh? I'm about ready to turn you into roadkill!
Please, don't turn me into anything! I just wanna be Wade. Are we nearly there yet?
No, Wade.
Are we nearly there?
You keep this up, you're not gonna get there at all.
Can you tell me a story?
No, Wade.
Let's play a game then. You know animal, mineral, or vegetable? I'll go first. I'm nanotechnology.
You're what?
Ooh, damn it. I gave it away. I wasn't supposed to say what I am. I'll start again. Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Hey, how about this? I'll tell you a story if you promise never to speak again.
I like stories.
Of course you do. This story's about a boy called Trisha.
Is Trisha a boy's name?
It doesn't matter.
Sounds weird.
He was weird. He was the smartest, toughest, weirdest kid in Canada. Well, in the Canadian border region of America.
Okay.
This boy, he had all the talent, charisma, and guile that a boy could have, but he didn't know what to do with it.
He should become a baseball player.
No, he shouldn't. Because he's not a fucking sellout idiot.
Or hockey player.
He did for a while, but his coach accidentally had a stick jammed up his ass. Right there, Los Santos. The end of the fucking earth.
This is the place! I seen it on the holiday card. So, this is Los Santos.
I guess it is.
I always wanted to come here.
But you got stuck in the desert.
It's still San Andreas.
Best part of the state.
I'm Buddy Delmont of Buddy's Truck. We're a family-owned and operated truck-driving outfit. Have you ever wanted to see the beauty of real America while popping Benzedrine and having sex with scary women in towns nobody's ever heard of? Well then, the trucking industry just might be for you. A job where you can smoke at work, poop in a coffee can and fling it out the window, and sleep at a rest stop surrounded by serial killers. Truck driving, it's the excitement of the open road, the joyful pleasures of the man alone in the middle of nowhere, slowly going mad at his own...
So, Michael, this is where dead men come back to life, huh? It's been nearly 10 years. But you'll keep for another day or so, huh, old friend? You motherfucking fuck! I grieved for you! You weren't even fucking dead. You were my best friend. Well, guess who's coming to shit on your doorstep, you fuck!
Cousin Floyd don't live here.
Los Santos, the city of shitheads. Where else would he be?
It's Vespucci Beach where he's staying. Will you tell me the story about that boy, Trisha?
Ah, yeah. Where were we?
Right. So, this kid, he could fly planes. So, he signed up for the Air Force to fly all day long and bomb villages and maybe, just maybe, drop the nuke. And it was all going well until one day, just before he got his wings, an evil witch in charge of psychological evaluations told him he was unstable and grounded him for life.
That's terrible.
It was. Sent him into a deep pit of doubt. Despair. And just then, just as he hit rock bottom, he met a fat, silver-tongued troll under a bridge.
That's cool. What was the troll's name?
Mike! Michelle!
A lady troll?
He had tits like one, but no, he was a boy.
Michelle is a funny name for a boy.
This was a funny boy. He sat under his bridge, robbing anyone who passed him by. Sometimes, he'd go into town and rob the shops and inns and such. And he persuaded our hero that maybe he should rob people too. And you know what? Little Trisha did rob people, and little Trisha was good at it.
And they lived happily ever after?
For a while. Until the troll met another troll in a strip club, and they fell in lust, and he bought her a pair of fake troll tits, even bigger than his real troll tits, so she could make more money stripping. Maybe a little on the side without call work, but you didn't hear that from me. Wow. And then she pushed out a pair of little trolls, and the big bad troll under the bridge went soft.
Hold on, what?
So little Trevor made a new friend called Brad, and he was thinking about cutting Mike off. When it all went to shit, and Mike got killed and Brad went to jail.
Did all the names just change, or am I missing something? Oh. We're near Floodcap. I seen it on iPhone map. I'll give you directions. Now keep going. Just straight over this one. It's a right up here. Go straight on here. This is the place, I think it is at least. Floyd! Floyd! It's up here, Trevor! Floyd, it's me, Wade!
Who?
Me, Wade, your cousin.
Who?
Your cousin! Fuck! He's come to visit you, you rude fuck. Now get up off the floor and fix me a fucking drink.
Oh, you, Wade. I heard you was off smoking meth somewhere.
No, not somewhere. Here, he's gonna smoke meth here. Give me a fucking lighter.
You can't smoke here.
Okay.
This is my girlfriend's place. She's at a business conference. You can't smoke here and you can't stay here.
How's it going, cousin? It's been a while.
Yeah, I ain't seen you since you was caught in Evelyn's bed.
That was never true.
You gotta go, both of you. My girlfriend, she'd kill me if she knew I had guests.
Well, it's not much of a girlfriend if she don't like your family. Now, would you get me a fucking drink? I'm not gonna ask you again.
Oh, yeah, okay. Wait, I ain't got no booze.
Then you go out and fucking get me something. You go too.